Okay, let's learn about calorimeter. Okay, there are two types of calorimeter. One is bomb calorimeter, another one is simple calorimeter. Okay, so now we shall focus on bomb calorimeter first. Okay, the most important thing to solve the problem is from the question itself, you need to know what is the formula used. Okay, so let us look at the question. Okay, it is said that, okay, CH4 is burned. Okay, and then it mentioned the word heat capacity. Heat capacity means we use capital C. Okay, so here I have highlighted heat capacity of calorimeter. When you write, you must write down capital C. Okay, then another one, the calorimeter contains 300 gram of water. Okay, once we see mass of water, means that we can straight away put MC delta T in our formula first. Okay, then it says that temperature rose from 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. Means we can calculate the change of temperature. Okay, so as we can see here, the heat capacity means, once you see the word heat capacity, means that you can use C delta T. So in this equation, in this calorimeter, there are two things that absorb heat. Okay, that is the water and also the calorimeter. Okay, now we look at the second question. Okay, also combusted in calorimeter, then it gives us changes of temperature, and then it gives us heat capacity. The word water is not mentioned in the question. Okay, if there's no water mentioned in the question, means we do not have to write MC delta T. Okay, but we have only C delta T. Okay, now another question, it says that this time it says that there is a 1.2 kilogram of bomb calorimeter. Okay, this time the mass refer to mass of calorimeter, and then it has a heat capacity. Okay, so we have capital C. Okay, once we have capital C, we know, okay. Then another one is, it says it also contains water, mass of water. And then we have changes of temperature. Okay, this question seldom asked in our exam. Okay, because usually we do not calculate the mass of calorimeter. But if you come across this question, so you have to be careful. We no longer use C delta T because the mass of calorimeter is given. Okay, last question here. Carbon is burned in calorimeter. Okay, it tells you it has water. Okay, water means you can straight away write MC delta T. And then temperature of water increased. Okay, we have temperature. So here it only mentioned water. It doesn't mention about heat capacity. So there is no C delta T here. Okay, so just remember you have to know your symbol very clear. And also know what is inside the question. Okay, is it water or only heat capacity of calorimeter? Okay. Heat of combustion, okay, refers to the heat released when one mole of substance is burned completely in excess oxygen, okay. Now, let's look at two different exercises here. The first one, it says 0.14 gram magnesium metal, okay, it is not the mass of calorimeter. Okay, then it says that it contains water. The bomb calorimeter contains water. Okay, straight away, I can write down MC delta T. If you don't want to write double D, it's also okay. Okay, understood that it represents water. Okay, and then we have temperature. Okay, then it tells us heat capacity. Heat capacity means we can write C delta T. So in the formula, there are two things, water and the heat capacity. Okay, then it asks us to calculate the enthalpy of combustion. Once you see the word enthalpy of combustion, you can label delta H, not C, combustion, then your final answer must contain negative and also the unit kilojoule per mole. It cannot be joule only. Okay, now how marks is given? Okay, so you need to write down heat release equals to heat absorbed by water and also heat absorbed by calorimeter. Then substitute your information. Okay, so what you calculate here, joule, is not referring to the heat released by 1 mole of magnesium. Okay, but if we want to calculate enthalpy of combustion, it must refer to 1 mole only. Okay, it must refer to 1 mole magnesium. Okay, so what we do is now we use the mass of magnesium. Okay, so we know that this is the number of mole. So this much of mole release this much of heat. Okay, so 1 mole release how much heat? Okay, when you calculate, it is just joule. It's not yet kilojoule. So remember, your final unit must be changed to kilojoule per mole. Okay, for enthalpy of combustion. Okay, another type of question. It tells you that it has heat capacity, capital C, and then it also has water. Okay, so meaning that is heat MC delta T plus C delta T. Okay, and then there's another interesting information given. It has give you the information of enthalpy of combustion. Okay, when it gives you the enthalpy of combustion, you can straight away right now means that 1 mole of magnesium will release 520 kilojoule of heat. Okay, before that, I want to pull back. Remember, there must be a negative here. Okay, now next one. Okay, so here it tells you that we can still calculate the Q heat release, but it's not referring to 1 mole. Okay, but we don't know how many mole of magnesium. Okay, so what we can do is we will use this information. Okay, 1 mole of magnesium release 520 kilojoule. So if we have 0.025 mole of magnesium, it will release 13.15. Okay, so now we've got the number of mole, then we can find the mass of magnesium. Okay, so that's all for the calorimeter, bomb calorimeter for enthalpy of combustion.